Equations are great for describing motion of an object. Sometimes you need to show a picture for what's going on. A mathematical picture called a graph. Graphs are often the best way to convey descriptions of real-world events in a compact form. Graphs of motion come in several types depending on which of the quantities, time, displacement, velocity, acceleration, are assigned to which axis. We will first understand the mapping of information about motion on the graph. Displacement time. Let's begin by graphing motion of a car. We will plot time on x-axis and displacement on y-axis. In the first second, it covers the distance of 1 meter. In 2 seconds, it covers the distance of 2 meters. 3 seconds, it covers the distance of 3 meters. In 4 seconds, it covers the distance of 4 meters. If we plot this motion, we will get graph something like this. Slope of the line is nothing but the speed of car. It is 1 meter per second. As it is a straight line, we can say that velocity is constant. Area covered gives us the total displacement covered by the car in 4 seconds. We will use ophysics.com simulation to understand displacement time graph when car is accelerated. Car is at rest and starting from origin with 0 initial velocity. It is accelerating at the rate of 5 meter per second square. The primary difference between this and previous graph is the shape of line. The relation between displacement and time is quadratic when the acceleration is constant, and therefore this curve is a parabola. When a displacement time graph is curved, it is not possible to calculate the velocity from its slope. Slope is a property of straight lines only. Such an object doesn't have a velocity because it doesn't have a slope. There is no single velocity under these circumstances. The velocity of an object must be changing. It's accelerating. Although car has no single velocity, it still does have an average velocity and a continuous collection of instantaneous velocities. The average velocity of an object can be found by dividing the total displacement by the total time, and instantaneous velocity is the slope of the line tangent to a curve at any point. We can say that on a displacement time graph, 1. Straight lines imply constant velocity. 2. Curved lines imply acceleration. 3. The y-intercept equals the initial displacement. 4. When two curves coincide, the two objects have the same displacement at that time. 5. Average velocity is the slope of the straight line connecting the endpoints of a curve. 6. Instantaneous velocity is the slope of the line tangent to a curve at any point. We will explore some more scenarios to understand displacement time graph better. 1. Blue car is ahead of red car by 20 meters. Velocity of blue car is 20 meters per second while that of red car is 10 meters per second. Cars are not accelerating. Blue car is ahead of red car by 20 meters. Initial velocity of blue car is 20 meters per second while that of red car is 10 meters per second. Blue car is not accelerating while red car is accelerating at 2 meters per second square. As the red car is accelerating, its graph is curved. Though its initial velocity is just half of the blue car, velocity of red car is increasing by 2 meters per second every second. When it catches a blue car after 12 seconds, its velocity at that instance is 33 meters per second. Both cars have zero displacement and zero initial velocity. Blue car is accelerating at the rate of 2 meters per second square, while red car is accelerating at 4 meters per second square. At the end of 25 seconds, blue car's velocity is 102 meters per second, while that of red car is 51 meters per second. As cars are accelerating, these velocities are instantaneous velocities and will change as time passes by. Negative slope does not automatically mean driving backward or walking left or falling down. The choice of signs is always arbitrary. About all we can say in general is that when the slope is negative, the object is traveling in the negative direction. On a displacement time graph, 1. Positive slope implies motion in the positive direction. Negative slope implies motion in the negative direction. Zero slope implies a state of rest. Velocity time graph. The variation in velocity with time for an object moving in a straight line can be represented by a velocity time graph. In this graph, time is represented along the x-axis and the velocity is represented along the y-axis. These graphs record objects' velocity at different times. In these graphs, higher means faster, not farther. The v is equal to 5 meter per second line is higher because the car is moving faster than the one with v is equal to 2 meter per second. These particular graphs are horizontal. The initial velocity of each car is the same as the final velocity at 7 seconds. It is also the same at every instance in between. The velocity of each of these cars is constant during the 7 second interval. Total displacement of blue car during the interval of 7 seconds is 14 meters. It is also equal to the area of shaded region. When the line on a velocity time graph is straight but not horizontal, the velocity is changing. Velocity of red car is changing faster than that of blue car. The lines on the graph for red and blue car have a different slope. The line with steeper slope experiences the fastest change in velocity, as in the case of red car. That car has the greatest acceleration. You should see that acceleration corresponds to slope and initial velocity to the intercept on the vertical axis. Since each of these lines has its intercept at the origin, cars were initially at rest. The initial velocity being zero does not mean that the initial position must also be zero. The lines on the graph are all straight lines. A straight line is a curve with constant slope. Since slope is acceleration on a velocity time graph, each of the car represented on this graph is moving with a constant acceleration. Where the graphs are curved, the acceleration would not have been constant. For this graph, we can say that red and blue cars are accelerating. Initial velocity of blue car is 0 while that of red car is 2 meter per second. However, blue car is accelerating faster than the red car. After 5 seconds, these lines meet, indicating that instantaneous velocity of both cars is same. For velocity time graph, we can say that 1. Slope equals acceleration. 2. The y-intercept equals the initial velocity. 3. When two curves coincide, the two objects have the same velocity at that time. 4. Straight lines imply uniform acceleration. 5. Curved lines imply non-uniform acceleration. Car is moving at the velocity of 2 meter per second. As velocity is constant, acceleration is zero. Velocity time graph for this type of motion is often a straight line. Car is moving at the velocity of 1 meter per second. It is accelerating at a rate of 1 meter per second square. Its velocity increases with time. Observe the slope of line on velocity time graph. Acceleration of the car is positive acceleration. When velocity of the car decreases with time, it is negative acceleration. It is also called as deceleration. Car is traveling with initial velocity of 2 meter per second. As acceleration is negative, it changes direction after some time. We discussed ways to capture data about objects' motion on graph. Use this or similar simulation to learn more about graphical representation of motion. Take this challenge. Look at this speed graph and tell how far away from the starting point this thing ended up.